You got Trey Jones, RJ Barrett, Jason Tatum, Zion, Wendell Carter Jr. All Duke team, maybe. Nice. One. Versus Davidson, Steph Curry.
Better than he is today. Pretty dying. there, the kind of ball movement coaches love to see.
We've got a 9-second overtime with the shot clock and the game clock. Here's Kennard, and it's good off the back of the rim and in.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
Gone 5-9 for the field here in the first. And the basket move. Thompson outside. Randall against Reddick. Randall kicks to Thompson. 5 to shoot. Booty down low. A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. The away team leading by a point. We'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. Kristaps Porzingis grew up in faraway Latvia, but thanks to his brother, developed a passion for
older brother. He's a big fan, but he always is.
But that's something different now for foreign players, isn't it? A lot more exposure to the NBA.
And KP, a fan of the culture, you saw him in cornrows as a kid. I think that helped prepare him for the transition.
And getting going again here in the second quarter. Very close game so far. And looking at what we've seen so far, guys, from the visiting team, what do you think?
Well, the offense is clicking, and they seem to have seized the momentum here early on.
Boy, it's been a really pretty thing to watch, executing their game plan to perfection.
They got AI. Those kind of displays of strength can get one team rolling.
It's been a major aspect of their offense in the early stages here. Their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range.
To the right side. Randall against Reddick. Here's Bowman. Bagley with the rebound. Gone 1-3 to start out the second quarter. Here's Kennard. And he banks in the lane. Kennard's got his second basket of the game.
Taking back the lead once more. Give these teams credit. Man, they are battling.
Boy, Greg, neither team willing to give an inch. And now they're able to seize the momentum. This has been a fascinating one to watch.
Bobby. of 8 from the floor here in the second quarter. 60% shooting. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. And for a while, they can get through it. It's interesting how quickly teams expect them to get up to speed. Case in point, RJ Barrett.
Yeah, I mean, he had unbelievable power already being asked to produce. Unfortunately, he's very mature for his age, and generally plays up to the level of competition.
Luke Kennard, he's checked in for AI.
What you like about Barrett is his all-around game. Personal guard, slash forward, wants to keep improving. Got to recognize the situation. Try to get a two-for-one.
Well, this is where the play call is crucial, right? If you're in a two-for-one, you've got to get the first shot quickly.
To the paint. A good finish at the rack off the swift feet. Bernie's got four this quarter.
And I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Carter dishes up to Tatum. 4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Out to the right wing. Good on. Offensive rebound. Finish shot by Carter.
Impossible to stop the putback when he's got that kind of position.
Agreed, great. But he'll get his hands on it inside and finish it off.
How about the activity level, the effort level? This team right now feeding off his energy.
And a game free from Curry. And some good action in the first two quarters as we reach halftime. The away team up 5. Thanks so much, David. We'll step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after this break.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Hey, welcome back to the NBA on 2K. Checking out the visiting team. Kenny?
I was super impressed with their shot selection. I think that was part of the strategy coming in. They wanted to be patient with the basketball, move it around, and get a high percentage looks. Obviously, that's going to be good.
And, big fella, let's get your thoughts on the home team.
Well, they're not matching up well defensively, giving up a lot of open looks, a lot of easy points. They're allowing close to high shooting.
And that's a wrap.
And as we get to this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. Has been just fantastic, around 65% tonight, getting exactly what they want, when they want it. They've got Porzingis. Steph Curry's out there with Thompson, and it's Mann in at the three, the small forward. That's Steve Kerr's 5 as we get into the second half. Thompson passes to Mann, and he uses the glass on the way.
That's just a terrific pass from Klay Thompson. My goodness.
Carter's got 6.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Jones against Curry. Pass to Porzingis. Thompson outside. It's Curry outside. Taylor pulls it down. Gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Here's Williamson. Terrific assist, a nice finish, solid play all around.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Passes it to Mann. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Yeah, easy call.
This is his first free throw of the game. And the first one at the line is good. So he gets them both. Gone 3 of 4 so far in the third quarter for the field. Pretty good start to the half. Here's Parker. Porzingis with the block.
This guy's showing great potential as a rim protector. Porzingis a threat to block shots anywhere, anytime.
48% for the field. Not bad at all.
Well, with this guy, Porzingis, you love not only the skill, but the passion he plays with. The descriptor passive with this guy.
Here's Parker. Banked in off the glass.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
No one here. lets it go. Gets an open look and hits. He has 7. And with Porzingis, as Dorsey mentioned, that energy he has is contagious.
Well, he is the prototypical modern NBA big, right? Porzingis can run the floor in transition. He can face up and shoot with range. He can put it on the deck and he can play out of the post. What more could you ask?
Pass to Pascal. Outside, Porzingis. Shot clock at 6. Pass to Pascal. Tatum pulls it down. Got 5 of 8 shots to fall for them in the third quarter. A nice 62% from the field. Redick with the bucket.
And the timing and rhythm with which Redick plays, what he is feeling right now.
And perimeter shooting, never more valuable. And that's been J.J. Redick's M.O. all along. An elite marksman who can hit from anywhere.
For Jones.
And looking down to numbers for Redick, how he performed last season. Averaged 18 points per, 2 assists, and 2 rebounds. Well, fans of this team will take this kind of production from him without hesitation.
I'll tell you, he has been a solid contributor. They have called his number, and he has delivered for them.
And that's now 7 points for Porzingis.
Porzingis knows he can get his shot anytime he wants.
The shot's good from Kennard.
There's 6 points on consecutive 3 balls. They're finding holes now in the deep.
Now here's Randle, guarded closely. Outside, Porzingis. Well, they get it back. Bagley with the rebound. Guard 7-10 on their field goal attempts here in the third. Tatum gets to Parker, to the left side wing. Shot's good by Kennard. Kennard's got 6 in the quarter.
The defense, a step slow, and you can see the result.
And J.J. Redick picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. There's 10 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Pass to Thompson. With 1 on the clock. And that would have counted, but his shot was off the mark this time. And so it's the visiting team with a sizable lead as the quarter wraps up. And a moment ago, inside the huddle with head coach Alvin Gentry.
Hey, let's keep it up, guys. Keep running, though. Get out and open the court and run all we want, all right?
Alvin Gentry satisfied with some of what he's seeing, but would like his guys to pick up the pace.
And there have been some opportunities in transition that they have yet to capitalize on that may have cost them support.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but strange things have happened. Kennard is out there with Barrett. Then there's Jason Tatum. Then it's Wendell Carter. And it's Williamson in at the 4 spot. Randle down low, guarded by Tatum. Porzingis can't hit.
And that's the battle. They haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
Quick job of getting up the floor and creating early offense.
You don't give the defense any chance to set up. Sometimes you just love an easy look.
There's Looney. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Curry's got 4 assists now tonight. Doris, you've accomplished so much in your award-winning career. What was your first experience of broadcasting?
Kevin, my first experience was I left coaching, and they put Providence College Women's Basketball on radio. That was the first ever game I got to call. It was so cool. Tell me yours. What was the very first? Did you study this? How did you get into broadcasting?
I did. Our high school had a radio station, and the first basketball broadcast was underneath the bleachers, looking through popcorn boxes and legs of the people that were standing in the bleachers so that I could see the court from the basement. Because that's where the telephone cables were.
Wow.
Incredible.
Incredible.
Carter right side. And a lot of contact.
contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. Doris basketball continues to gain in popularity around the world, doesn't it? It's amazing to me.
It does. Adam Silver, the commissioner, has said, I believe we can be the number one spot in the world. Obviously, they have to overcome the soccer, and that's popularity. But think about this moment, how inclusive the game basketball is. The love spans across gender, race, ethnicity, religious affiliation. The best part about the game of basketball is this, Kevin. When you're growing up and trying to get better, you need a ball, you need a hand, you don't need anything else.
That is so well said. Second chance opportunities. Williamson explosive into the air with the touch and concentration to finish. And really, for some reason, just not a big part of their offense. They're hard to get into a rhythm when you're getting so few opportunities at the rim. Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there. The first one falls. He's off on the second. Well, you have to be a fan of the way Kevon Looney plays, the former UCLA Bruin. He puts in the work on the defensive end, Norris, and it shows.
No doubt. He has evolved to be the kind of player who is often asked to guard the wings, sometimes even point guards. Just think back to last year's playoffs. He had to guard the likes of James Harden, Kawhi Leonard, Kyle Lowry. This guy is so gifted as a defender, and he's only getting started.
Here's Pascal. A shot by Thompson. No one to round. And they come right back with their own three-pointer.
Klay Thompson is not about to let a three go unanswered. Big time shot.
Here's Mann. This is the three. Gone an outstanding 4-5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. Jones, no longer.
Going for that shot in that situation is something that isn't going to help the offense.
And in a way, by taking that one, he's bailing out the defense. It's just too easy to stop.
Tatum passes to Williamson. Now Jones kicks to Tatum. There's the triple. And that comes off the assist by Jones. But the truth is, they've had control of this game.
And I couldn't agree more. What makes it that much more impressive, they're doing it on the road.
Curry passes to Looney. Second chance effort. It's rebounded by Barry. And they can just let the clock run out here. Cannot argue with the W. That one falls. And once they smelled blood in the water, you could see the killer instinct take over.
And you want to save your best for last. Tonight, they've done that and then some.
Curry passes to Mann. And the three off target. And so it's a victory for the road team in this one. This crowd was stunned by the manner. All right, David, thank you. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony.